What makes you think your mom might be ready to give up on EJ?
Like I said, I told her she's obviously still in love with you, and she's just too stubborn to admit it to herself.
Oh, that obvious, huh?
Yes, Dad. And I also told her that she'd end up a lot happier if she just dumped EJ and went back to you.
And what did she say?
Well, she mostly listened. But she said she does love you. And I know she's going to think about what I said.
Okay,
I mean, it seems like a no-brainer to me. She walked in on EJ in bed with Nicole, and then he threw her out of his house.
Right. No surprise there.
Right. And don't get your hopes up, but I think there's a decent chance that she's signing those divorce papers as we speak.
What are you doing here, Samantha? Do I have to threaten to throw you out again?
Oh, don't bother threatening anything. I'm not going anywhere.
Then I'll have to inform security that there's an intruder in the house.
EJ, put the phone down and stop getting your knickers in a knot. I brought you something.
What sort of papers are those?
You know exactly what kind of papers these are, EJ. They are the divorce papers that you promised to serve me with while you were in bed with Nicole. Aren't you going to take them? What's the matter with you? Just take the papers. What? Well, EJ, is this your wedding ring? The one that I gave you? What a surprise.
Dr. Evans is possessed by the devil for a second time. But you're not Marlene Evans anymore, right? You're Satan himself.
Don't listen to him, Ben. John's obviously gotten to him. But he hasn't gotten to you. After the way your father treated you and your mother, you know never to trust an abuser.
Of course not. So it's all lies, Ben. John has never laid a finger on Marlena. That is the demon inside of her trying to get you to trust her. And Marlena is my mother-in-law, and I love her. And if she told me that John were hitting her, I would believe her. But this is not her.
I think your pronoun you want is she. He's just trying to discredit me so nobody believes the truth of what I'm saying. Happens to women all the time. Look, Ben, I don't feel safe here anymore. Okay, and I think you need to find your wife, so I think it's time for us to get out of here.
Thank you so much for calling me, Susan. And don't worry, I believe you now. I've locked all the doors, and no one is getting in here. Nobody is going to get to me or my baby.
Like sand through the hourglass, so are the days of our lives.
Sorry, Susan. Someone started knocking, and it's Belle. No, I promise I will not let her in unless I know that it's really her. And thank you so much for calling me.
Sierra,
I'll take care too. Okay.
Are you okay?
What is Claire's safe word?
What?
Claire's safe word. What is it? You're not getting in unless you know.
It's box top. Will you please just open the door?
Thank God, you're okay. Wait, how did you know about Claire's safe word? Sean told me. Okay, well, he just called me, and the reception was terrible, but all I got was that you were in danger, and that I needed to come right over. What is going on? Well, Sean is on his way to the cabin.
Okay, why?
Because Ben is there. And as far as I know, he's there alone with your mother.
You two aren't going anywhere.
What are you gonna do? You gonna arrest us? You gonna victimize the victims?
No, you are no victim. I'm gonna untie John and he's gonna tell you the truth.
And who are you going to believe, Ben? Somebody you barely know? Or somebody you've known for a long time who believes in you, who has always helped you believe in yourself, right?
Right, this is Sean. Cecilia's brother.
He didn't think you were good enough for a sister. He still doesn't.
Oh, I can't get this gag off.
Don't listen to his lies. Or John's.
This nobody is lying but her. It's because she's scared to death. What John is going to say about her. That's why she locked him in that crypt and she left him there to die. Like, it's true. Or she wants John out of the way because he knows the truth. All John wants is his wife back. Damn it. The wounds just got tight again, didn't they?
He wasn't even there. He doesn't know what happened there.
Well, I was there on Thanksgiving, and I saw it. I saw it up close. Then she had eyes like fire, and her voice was not Marlena's. Come on, John, hang in there. I'm going to get you untied here. Come on.